Welcome to the AB Acton Boxborough Colonials hosting the Westwood Academy Gregos, where AB is hoping to win against a very good opponent tonight.
Hey, the fans are pumped up and so am I. This is going to be a crazy game. Westford vs. AB is always very close. This is going to be a great game. Except for the tip. That was a very boring tip. Sorry, fans.
Everyone was ready to go, and both players jumped a little early for that tip-off.
You can tell that this gym is ready to explode.
And now we'll have the tip go for a third time because there was a jump ball on the tip.
Okay, we got to get it together. Just get this game going.
And the referee's going to throw it up for a third time.
And third time's the charm.
AB wins the tip. AJ Goddell springing it off the court.
AB tries to run their offense through their center, Kevin LaFrancis, trying to get it down low to him right now. Good passing around the perimeter, but good defense. Good shot by Joey Flannery. Just misses, though.
He may have missed that one, but that's a good shot inside the paint. Westford now taking up the court. Westford, last time they played, got off to a hot start, not missing any shots early in the game.
Yeah, especially senior guard Matt Ellis. Seemed like he was hitting every single shot for Westford. Hopefully they can slow him down early.
Good defense by AB, forcing a tough shot, and Westford with the miss. And it's going to be AB ball.
On that play, you see AB just getting out on the shooters real quick, and it's nice to see that early on. AB's got to stay consistent, though.
Jake Pilecki, a big man, bringing the ball off the court.
Surprising play. We actually saw this 2 years ago with Pilecki bringing up the ball sometimes. Good pass.
Ben Hoban open for three.
Got it!
A three-pointer to start the game for AB. Ben Hoban hits it for three.
This is a big-time game, and these players have to come ready to play. Ben Hoban showed that he's a big-time player. He's been on the team for 3 years, and he's not afraid of the big moment.
Westwood missed a shot. AB with the rebound, going the other way.
Joey Flannery bringing out the ball. Gets fouled. He's just so big and fast. It's hard to play defense on him without fouling him. You see a sea of yellow in the AB crowd. Everyone's pumped up. Everyone came out. It's going to be a great night.
This gym was very crowded during the girls' game. Everyone getting ready to cheer on the AB team tonight.
And it was actually a very exciting girls' game, too. Trying to get it down low to LaFrancis. Just can't find it. Ryan Jan playing good defense down low on LaFrancis.
Ben Hoban pulling up, misses the shot.
Tough shot right there, and the fans are going to give it to him.
He's just got to move on to the next play.
And we know he can hit those shots. He just hit a three earlier, so he's a big-time player. Good defense right there.
And called for a block. I'm not sure I agree with that call.
Looked
like Ben Hoban was playing very good defense.
Yeah, that's about as good as it gets, but sometimes the calls just don't go your way. Good job by AB, just staying with everyone. Tough shot right there.
Ball gets tipped out and Westford's gonna recover it. Gets a full shot clock.
That time you wanna see AB just grab on it with two hands, not just tip it out. Good defense right here. AB's gotta move quick.
Good ball movement by Westford, trying to get an open shot. Late in the shot clock now, they need to get something going.
Good defense by AB.
Called off of AB, gonna be Westford ball. 7 seconds for them to get a shot off.
AB's gotta get out on that shooter.
And a good pass by Westford to get an easy layup.
Sloppy defense right there. They just gotta have better communication.
AJ Goddell doing a good job with the pressure defense, getting it up the court.
A lot of pressure right here, but AB's just got to get in that triple threat position and stay strong.
A foul called against Westford's Ryan Jan. AB's going to be inbounding the ball.
And you know it's going to be a physical game when these two powerhouses meet.
Every game these two teams play is a thriller.
It seems like it always comes down to a last minute shot or just really down to like the last 2 points.
Jake Bielecki with a great finish. Matt Ellis setting up Westford's offense. Good move by Westford and a tip-in for two. AB's got to box out on those rebounds.
Yeah, maybe take a lesson from the Celtics-Lakers last night. They got to box out.
Ben Open with a crazy drive, almost gets it to go.
It's a good move. He's missed on his last two shots, but they've been good attempts, so he's got to keep going up with that.
Westford misses another shot. Last time they played, that kid did not miss a single shot, so AB's got to continue to play good defense like that, possession on him.
Yeah, just close out. Ben Hoban did a great job right there being all over him. As looks like the foul's called on Westford on the floor.
Looked like he grabbed on to Kevin LaFrancis as he tried to get the ball inside.
And we've seen that every game. Just whoever's playing AB, they get into early foul trouble. If AB keeps this up, they just got to hit their free throws, and it's going to be a huge advantage.
Ben Hoban gets the ball in the inbound. And AB getting try to get it back inside, but it's not there. And Pilecki drives to the basket.
Oh, he's going to have a big night tonight. He's feeling it early on.
Pilecki shows up for the big games, and he's got 4 points early in this game.
The four-year varsity player, Jake Pilecki, seeing this type of big game plenty of times. He's ready for it.
With 3:30 left in the first quarter, AB's leading 7-4.
AB trying to push it right here. AJ Godhell finds Joey Flannery on the corner.
Good cross-court pass to Pilecki for three. Off the mark.
Everyone wanted that so
great
bad.
Great hustle. Great job by Kevin LaFrancis.
Somebody's
got to
come to the ball right here.
Pilecki driving to the basket. Off the mark, but great rebound by AB.
Oh, should have been a foul. I do not agree with that, but you like to see AB getting all the offensive rebounds.
Referee said that was a clean play. Westford with the ball now.
AB's got to play with a lot of heart if they want to win this game. It's just going to come down to whoever wants it more. These teams are equally talented, just who puts in the more effort.
And a travel called against Westford. Looked like he shuffled his feet when he tried to drive to the basket.
And Jake Pilecki's defense will make you do that. He'll make you second guess. He's a big guy, and he moves around really quick. Just a great defender.
Joey Flannery now bringing the ball up for AB.
One of the great ball handlers of AB history. Another move by Jake Pilecki.
Great drive to the basket. Jake Pilecki gets another one to go.
Hey, Jake Pilecki's just saying he is going to be the star of this game. He looks like he's ready to take every shot, and he's making great moves.
If my adding is correct, it looks like he has 6 early points for AB.
Yeah, I think it is, Steve. You're pretty good at math.
Thank you. AB's getting the ball now. Westford looks like he's going to continue to pressure full court.
And you know, AB's got these two superstar captains in LaFrancis and Joey Flannery, but sometimes you forget they have all these great role players to help out.
The entire team can do a bunch of things. And great ball movement, getting AJ Godhelp for three.
Got it!
AJ Godhelp knocking down the open three-pointer, giving AB an 8-point lead early in this game.
AB's pumped up right now. They got to play good defense, keep up the intensity. AB fans getting into it.
Jump shot for Westford, way off the mark. AB's going the other way. Jake Pilecki bringing it up the court. Great pass to Joey Flannery.
Oh, Joey Flannery, clear the lane. He's ready for takeoff.
AB with 1:23 left in this first quarter has a 10-point lead, 14-4. Coming out of that timeout, Westford inbounding the ball, bringing it up the court.
Sorry, my associate's a little bit distracted right now. Big game situation. Looks like AB's going into a 2-3 zone.
Matt Ellis with an open three-pointer just off the mark. He's a very good three-point shooter.
It's great to see he's missing early on. Last game, he lit us up pretty bad.
Ben Hoban with another three-pointer in and out.
AB's already hit 2 3-pointers. They've looked pretty good so far.
Ryan Jan for three, but Westford knocks it down.
Quick three, but it was good defense right there. Ben Hoban was all over him. Just a half second too late. It's tough to see those shots go in.
Billy Jackman bringing it up for AB right now, coming off the bench.
Yeah, he's second year in varsity. Played a little bit last year, but he's really picked up his role this year. Good move by Joey Flannery.
And Joey Flannery gets it to go.
So much power, so much grace. Joey Flannery. AB's looking like LeBron James out there.
AB's looked very good early in this game, especially with those great moves by Joey Flannery, a.k.a. LeBron James.
Yeah, they might have to start calling him that now.
Oh. Great defense, but a foul's called.
It's tough. Jake Blakey's pumped up, and this is really going to help out the defense.
4 seconds are remaining in this first quarter. As of now, AB has a 9-point lead, but Westford's shooting 2 free throws. And they miss the first one.
And the fans are chanting Bieber Fever. I think it's because of the player's hair.
He's got the flow of Justin Bieber.
Yeah, I don't know if he has the voice, though.
And he knocked down the second one. AB has 4 seconds to get a shot off. Joey Flannery taking it up, going to the basket, and gets fouled.
What a move, Joey Flannery. Again, right to the basket with power.
Joey Flannery took exactly 4 seconds to get to the basket. 0.4 seconds left on the clock, and he's going to the line shooting two. And he makes the first one. Coming into the game now for AB is 00 senior Sam Eisenberg.
Great rebounder, Sam Eisenberg. They're going to put him in for a little bit. Maybe he can get an offensive board right here.
And Flannery makes both of them, giving AB a 10-point lead. And that closes out the first quarter. At the end of the first quarter, your Acton-Boxborough Colonials lead at 18-8. Coming into the second quarter, your Acton-Boxborough Colonials are leading the Westford Academy Grey Ghosts 18-8.
AB's played very well so far, both offensively and defensively. Jake Pilecki's looked like a standout so far with 6 points. They just got to keep this up.
Westford trying to get ball movement to beat the zone. And another three-pointer for Ryan Jan.
It's those cross-court passes that'll kill you. If they just overload one side of the court, somebody's going to be open on the other side. But AB's just got to be wary of that and get to the shooter.
Billy Jackman drives to the basket and gets fouled. Shooting foul going to the line, shooting two. Back to the AB defense. They need to close out very quickly on the Westford shooters.
Yeah, Westford's got a lot of three-point shooters. They can kill you from deep, as we saw last game. I mean, if you give them just a tiny bit of space, they'll make you pay.
Billy Jackman missed the first free throw. It was very hard last game for AB to stop Westford shooters early in the game. They just need to make sure they don't let Westford get easy shots in this game.
Yeah, if they can make sure that Westford doesn't have confidence shooting the ball, that's going to go a long way late in this game.
Ball moving by Westford, getting an easy layup. AB needs to get some rotation to not allow easy layups like that one.
Yeah, somebody's got to be there to drop down and make sure that dump off pass isn't there.
Oh, a steal by Westford.
Looked like a backcourt right there, but no call. Another three by Ryan Jan. Same exact spot, same exact shot. Hits it back to back.
Ryan Jan is killing the AB defense with 3 3-pointers early in this game. AB's leading by three, and Jake Pilecki drives to the basket for two.
Wow, Jake Pilecki has stunned me right now.
Jake Pilecki doing a great job early in this game scoring.
Ryan Jan goes right back at it.
Ryan Jan is picking up his team and helping them stay in this game.
They got to make sure they can shut him down early on. He's getting off to a really hot start.
Joey Flannery driving to the basket and gets fouled.
Again, that's the third time you've seen him just drive to the hoop with strength and he gets the blocking foul.
His speed and strength combination makes it hard for anyone to stop him.
Yeah, frankly, I just feel bad for the Westford defenders. It's tough.
AB inbounding the ball underneath.
Trying to get it down low to Pilecki. You can tell he's having a big night. Great pass. I don't know how he saw him there.
AB trying to get it inside again, but now pulling it out. Great move by Kevin LaFrance. That's again an easy two.
With the night Jake Pilecki's having, you forgot about Kevin LaFrance, but he's going to have those kind of moves every night.
They cannot let him shoot that. Ryan Tran has 4 3-pointers for Westford.
He's hitting everything right now. They got to do something. Maybe bring a double team or just rotate better.
Good ball movement by AB to get it inside, but they can't finish.
Great pass right there. Just barely off accuracy.
With 5:30 left in the first half, AB's leading 23-21.
No surprise here. Ryan Jan has the ball.
Aggressive defense by Jake Pilecki trying to get a steal. But his teammates make great rotations to play good defense and force a turnover.
There you go, right there. Ryan Jan travels there. He hit a few shots, but mental mistakes like that will cool him off real quick.
AB needs to continue to have tough defensive possessions like that one.
And it's really won them games all throughout this season. AB's defense has just been impeccable.
Joey Flannery for three.
Got it!
Great play off of a pick, getting an open three-pointer, and he knocks it down.
Yeah, AB's been scoring everywhere tonight. Just three-pointers inside, very well-balanced offense. Now if they can stop Ryan Jan, that's going to be tough. But Matt Ellis gets the ball. Matt Ellis missing early, and that's a good sign.
If he gets going, though, AB will need to make sure he doesn't get open shots.
Yeah, the combo of him and Ryan Jan could be deadly.
Jake Pilecki just misses it, taking it to the basket, but Kevin LaFrance with the putback.
The down low duo right now is unstoppable. It's either Pilecki or LaFrance scoring.
These two guys have played varsity together for 4 years, and they're showing how good they are tonight.
Wide open. Awful defense by Westford, just leaves LaFrancis wide open. Good presence by A.J. Godhoff to make the pass.
AB on a bit of a run, leading by 9 with 4:10 left in the first half. Coming out of that timeout, Westford is going to inbound the ball. AB's been on a bit of a run of late, extending their lead to 9.
Yeah, for Westford, really the only thing they had going was Ryan Jin, and boy did he hit some tough shots. But it looks like he's slowing down a tiny bit. Good sign for AB.
AB getting good rotation and forcing tough passes so Westford can't get the shot off.
Yeah, great job by AB to just be there when somebody drives.
Good closeout by Jake Pilecki causing a tough shot, and AB's going to get the ball.
AB getting back to basics, playing good defense. It's going to win them this game.
A.J. Godhoff bringing it up for A.B.
A.J.'s already hit 1 3 tonight. He's played good so far.
The entire A.B. team's playing very well so far. Especially this guy with the ball, Jake Pilecki, he's done very good.
Yeah, he's looking to make a move every time he gets the ball, and for good reason. He is on fire.
And a push-off called against Kevin LaFrance is trying to get position down low.
You know, those calls are tough to make. There's down low, there's a lot of pushing both ways. It's tough to make those calls.
I Westford bringing the ball up now. 3:20 left in the first half. AB leading 30-21.
AB's got to stay strong right here. Westford's their rival. Don't want to lose to them again. Got to play tough.
And especially in a game that means as much as this one, the winner of this game will secure first place in the DCL.
Jake Blucky wanted that three bad. And you know, some people said we couldn't do it with the loss of Sam Longwell and Wes Schroll, but we've proven this year that we can win. We're just a winning town, you know? I mean, we produce championships, and that's all I got to say.
AB with the ball now. Joey Flannery trying to get something going. Good ball movement, getting it inside.
Good hustle by Westford right there. AB's got to get back and play good transition defense.
Westford misses a fast break layup.
Good job by AB getting back, making sure there was nothing easy.
Joey Flannery putting a move on.
Tough shot right there.
Rebound gets tipped around, but Westford comes up with it.
AB's got to play good defense. Steal by Ben Hoban.
Ben Hoban going to the basket and gets it for two.
Tricky move. Ben Hoban had only one man to beat, and he finishes with some grace.
Westford Academy lost the ball on the dribble, and Ben Hoban just went the full length of the court for a layup.
Yeah, Ben Hoban just moves around the court very swiftly. It's just a pretty player to watch.
Tough shot by Ryan Chan, but he gets it to go again.
You know, normal people don't really hit that shot, but Ryan Jan's playing at another level right now.
He's been a superstar for Westford so far this game.
But so has Jake Blecki. He gets the ball right here. Tough shot.
Just off the mark. 1:20 left in the first half. AB leading by 9, 32-23.
AB's hit some tough shots early, but they got to make sure they still get good ball movement and not settle for those tough shots.
Westford driving to the basket, gets it to go. AB's defense needs to play every possession. They can't let easy layups like that one happen too often.
Yeah, Westford's going to get on a run if they keep playing defense like this. AB's just got to buckle down, play good on both sides of the ball.
Tough call. Referee calls a travel on Kevin LaFrance. It looked like he only used 2 feet, but referee disagrees.
Yeah, you know, maybe the ref's got to read the rule book. In my book, 2 steps is fine. Good D by Joey Flannery, and Ryan Jan misses that time.
They're forcing tough shots for Ryan Jan, and he'll continue to take them. He's been very hot so far, but the defense has been tough on him the second quarter.
Yeah, and it's nice to see how AB's... Oh, great and one play by Kevin LaFrancis. Great at finishing with contact.
Great entry pass to get it down low, and LaFrancis goes straight up and one.
But as I was saying, it's nice to see AB come back and still play good defense after they see Ryan Jan hit these tough shots. They're still playing good defense. They're still getting out on the shooters, and it's really paid off. Kevin LaFrancis, a big guy, but a very good free throw shooter as he gets the line more than anyone we've seen in this DCL.
It seems like he gets a bunch of free throws every game. 20 seconds left in this first half. AB's leading 34-25. Westford will probably hold for the last shot.
Let's play good defense right here. No fouls. Just move with your feet.
Ref calls a foul on Ben Hoban. AB had fouls to give, though. They still have 3 more until 1-1. So AB can foul if they want to stop a drive to the basket.
Last shot for Westford right here. Matt Ellis taking it. Tough shot.
Tough
somehow
finish.
Goes in. And time expires.
At the end of the first half, the Acton Boxborough Colonials lead the Westford Academy Grey Ghosts 34-27. We're about to begin the second half of the AB Westford Academy game, where AB's leading 34-27.
It was a heated first half. Each team went on a bunch of runs. Jake Pilecki was big for AB, and Ryan Jan was big for Westford. But each team just played very well on both sides of the floor.
Everyone on both teams is stepping up for this big game.
Tough shot right there by Jake Pilecki. He's played well so far, but he can't settle for those jumpers.
Kevin LaFrancis inbounding the ball.
Deep long pass, but Hoban gets to it.
They need to hurry to get a shot off. Under 5 seconds on the shot clock, and Ben Hoban driving to the basket. Off the mark and a loose ball foul called against Kevin LaFrancis.
Tough call right there. Kevin LaFrancis just going hard for the ball. But you like to see that. Those are the hustle plays AB needs to make. They got to play with some heart, play with some energy. Let's win this. I'm getting pumped up right now.
The fans for AB have the energy. The players have the energy. See how they play the second half.
They got to shut down Ryan Jan. Open shot right there as the ball goes off Ben Hoban. But as I was saying, open shot right there. Can't let him get that open again.
He hit 4 3-pointers in the first half and a bunch of mid-range jump shots. AB needs to make sure he doesn't get open.
Yeah, he went on a tear, but he looks to be cooling down a little bit, but that's no excuse. AB's got to still play really good defense and not let him go off again. Good switching by AB.
Westford getting some ball movement, getting it to the senior captain, Matt Ellis, trying to get something going.
Ben Hoban all over him.
Ben Hoban's played great defense all night. And a foul called against AB late in the shot clock. Referee bailing out Westford, who couldn't get a shot off, and AB's going to have to play another 30 seconds of defense.
Yeah, it's tough. It's just tiring 30 seconds playing good defense, and now they got to go right back at it. But if any defense can do this, it's got to be AB's.
AB has a very good defense, and they've played very well when they've played man tonight.
Tough shot for Matt Ellis right there. Gets it right back. Misses again. AB's going the other way.
AB bringing the ball up the court, slowing it down. Jake Pilecki to the basket, off the mark.
And you've seen him take tough shots as of late, but he's just got to get back to what got him those points in the first place, going strong to the hoop. He's got that big frame, and he's really stronger than mostly anybody on the court. So
good defense by AB, good help defense, and Ben Hoban open for three, off the mark.
Yeah, thanks, Steve. I was rambling there.
Ben Hoban hit one early in the game. We're going to ignore that rambling. And it goes out of bounds off the ricochet off the rim.
Maybe he's got to keep up the intensity on defense. I like to see the crowd get into it right now.
Westford's trying to set picks to get their shooters open, but AB's switching well and playing very good defense. A jump shot made by number 10 for Westford, a big man.
Just too open right there. Gotta be quicker to the ball on those shots. If Westford can do one thing right, it's hit open shots.
A grab by Westford, trying to deny the ball from getting inside.
Nothing new here. Kevin LaFrancis just too big. They gotta foul him if they wanna stop him.
Looks like one of the goals of the Westford game plan has been to stop Kevin LaFrancis down low, but he's still getting things to go.
Yeah, he's had a relatively quiet night, but this AB offense has been very balanced, and it's working out great.
AB's leading by 5, 34-29 early in this third quarter.
Good move by Ben Hoban, trying to get something inside.
Joey Flannery pulls up. Just misses.
Such a good shot. Just barely misses right there, but a good take by Joey Flannery.
And a block is called. Not sure about that one.
Fundamental right there. That was such a good charge, but just don't get the call. And the fans don't like it.
Looked like Joey Flannery beat the man to the spot, had his feet set, and took the charge, but the referee decides to call it a block. Matt Ellis open for three for Westford off the mark. And
good
Kevin
rebound.
LaFrancis fights for the rebound.
Heck of a rebound right there. A lot of effort, and you see that every night from Kevin LaFrancis, fights for every single board with high intensity.
Westford pressuring full court now, trying to make it tough for AB to get it up the court.
But AB's seen full court pressure almost every game this season, and it has not fazed them. They've done a great job breaking it.
They did another good job that getting up the court with ease.
Ooh, tough steal right there. Joey Flannery got a little bit blindsided.
Good effort by Jake Pilecki, tipping the ball, almost getting a steal.
And he's pumped up. He's ready for this big game. He's playing good on offense and defense.
He's a very high-energy player and has played very well all night. An open three-pointer for Westford. Looked like someone got caught on the other side of the court behind another player. And Westford's gone on a run to begin the second half. AB calling a timeout. AB calling the timeout there, trying to slow down Westford as they have a run to begin this second half.
Yeah, it was a very good call to make that timeout. Westford hit a three, and that's really the only way they're going to beat you now. They're a great three-point shooting team, and you can't let them get on fire.
AB looking like they're trying to get it inside to LaFrancis, but Westford's continuing to front the post, make it difficult.
Yeah, coming out of that timeout, Westford's played with high intensity, making sure the ball can't get down low to Kevin LaFrancis, but he's been fighting hard all night.
AB's had a good lead at halftime, but Westford's really come back in this game on a bit of a run, like a 7-0 run to start. Not exactly sure about the numbers to start the second half.
Yeah, but this game's been really close, and no team's really had the decisive advantage.
Good passing to get an open layup, but it just doesn't get it to go.
Tough to see right there. Kevin LaFrancis hasn't had a big night scoring, but you can still see he's got a big impact off the ball. They have to double him almost every time, and it's opening up shots for everyone else.
Good job by AB fighting through the screens to not allow an open shot and forcing a tough shot for Westford.
You can tell right now, Ryan Jan is forcing up some bad shots. He was hot early on, but he's definitely cooled down here. Maybe he's got to keep up this intensity on defense. Good play by Pilecki. A.J. Gotthelf diving for it. Almost gets it twice.
A.J. diving for the ball twice and gets called for the foul.
That's a bad foul right there.
A.J. went for the ball, and then the Western player ran into A.J.
Yeah, I don't care about the foul. That was an amazing effort play. A.J. Gotthelf diving for the ball, not once, but twice. Almost gets it both times, but unfair foul right there.
It's a very tough foul. A.J. Gotthelf did great that play, but Westford now has the ball.
Billy Jackman's really got to step up right here.
Got to play some good defense. And A.B. forces a turnover.
Out of bounds off Westford. A.B.'s going to bring up the ball against this full court press. Jake Pilecki bringing up the ball. Trying to get it down low to Jake Pilecki against the smaller defender.
Great move, but just doesn't get it to go. But going to the line, shooting two.
You can tell they're going to Jake Pilecki often. They're going to put that smaller defender on him. He's just going to go at him every time.
AB looking for their first points of the second half. Pilecki makes the first one. The AB crowd and the Westford crowd are going at it, taunting each other, trying to make their impact on the game more than each other's.
And they're just trying to outdo each other with these clever chants back and forth.
Pilecki makes both free throws, giving AB a 5-point lead.
Ooh, bad rotation. Oh! Joey Flannery somehow, I don't know how he did it. I think he blocked it off the backboard.
and almost goes the other way with the layup, but fouls trying to get his own rebound. But that was a great defensive play to not allow an easy layup for Westford.
Yeah, I was about to say bad rotation, and then Joey Flannery comes out of nowhere with that. Great athleticism play right there.
2:40 left in this third quarter. AB's leading 36-31, and what it's going to look like is going to be a thriller to the end.
As it always is between AB and Westford. Hey, when you pay for that ticket coming into the building, you know you're in for a surprise. Oh, great block by Jake Blackie.
Great defense all night by AB, and that play just shows how good they've been.
Trying to get it over half court.
Joey Flannery driving to the basket, kicks it out for three.
Ah,
off the mark, but AB gets the rebound. Francis gets it tipped out when he's trying to go up, but AB gets the ball back.
And you got to give Ryan Ginn credit right there. He's playing great defense on the much bigger defender. But still, Kevin LaFrancis has had a big impact on this game.
As he does every game. LaFrancis, great pass to A.J. Godhelf. Off the mark.
Good passing right there to free up A.J. Godhelf for the three.
A.B. hasn't made a ton of shots the second half, but they got to keep shooting them because they will make them.
Yeah, they got to fall down sometime.
Westford gets a shot to go. The lead's down to three.
Tough shot right there, but if you can make them take those crossover fadeaway jumpers like that every time, I don't think they're going to hit them.
LaFrancis gets the ball and goes to the line shooting two. With 1:30 left in this third quarter, AB's leading 36-33. LaFrancis makes the first one.
Blicky coming out, trying to get some rest on the bench, saving for the fourth quarter, but Joe Yuli coming in here. He's been a great player off the bench. High energy, always hustling for every rebound.
Francis misses the second one. AB's played their starters for most of the game, but it looks like to close out the third quarter, Coach K is trying to get his starters some rest for the finish in the fourth.
Yeah, and you know it's going to be a tiring fourth quarter. These teams are just going at it back and forth. No clear advantage, as I said earlier. Good defense by Westford, but sloppy pass right there, trying to get it down low to LaFrancis.
Westford's made it tough all night for AB to get the ball inside, fronting the post, making it so no easy pass can get inside.
Yeah, and it's hard to stop Kevin LaFrancis from getting possession, but they've seemed to do a great job so far.
A blocked shot, and AB's going to get the ball. Ben 40 Hoven. Seconds left in the quarter.
Good passing around the perimeter. And looks like a foul called on Ryan Jan down low. A little bit too aggressive fighting for position.
Just trying to keep LaFrancis away from the basket. That's his, Ryan Jan's third foul. One more and Westford will have to worry about him fouling out. He's been huge all night for them.
Yeah, I don't really see what their offense can do without him right now. He's been great for them. And if they can stop him from scoring, then it's going to be a tough night for Westford. Good pass by Joe Yuli. Getting it out to Ben Hoban. Trying to move the ball around against this forceful Westford defense.
AB trying to get something late in the shot clock now. They need to get something off. And a fadeaway by Jake Pilecki off the mark. But LaFrancis with the rebound and gets fouled.
And you've seen it time and time again. Kevin LaFrancis making the miraculous offensive board, and he's going to the line for two.
It's too tough for Westford to stop. He's too big, too strong, and too powerful.
So cliche. awesome.
11, just under 11 seconds left in the quarter. AB leading by 4. But Francis makes the first one. LaFrancis makes both of them.
Got to play good defense right now. Westford's going to get the last shot.
Westford taking a quick shot. Get it to go. AB might have a chance to throw one off, but they decide not to. And at the end of the third quarter, AB leads Westford Academy 39-35. Okay, we're about to begin the fourth quarter where your Acton Boxborough Colonials lead it 39-35.
And you know when this fourth quarter comes around, it's going to be a tight game. Come down to the last shot. Tough shot right there by Westford.
AB's been up the whole game, but Westford's kept it close. And this run by Westford has got as close as it's been this whole game.
And again, Jake Pilecki going to the line. He's made some crazy shots, and he's been playing really well this game.
There's a bit of anticipation going through the crowd, knowing that this game's going to go down to the line, like almost every Westford AB game.
Yeah, and they're just excited, waiting for that last minute or so. That's where you see the best basketball come out. Jake, these two teams are just so evenly matched. It's hard to get such an advantage over the other. They just play so well together.
Every game they've played the past few years has been a thriller, and this one looks to add on to that legacy of tight games.
Yeah, it's like Celtics-Lakers right here. It's as good as it gets.
AB playing good defense now. AJ got off covering Ryan Jan. Stripping the ball away, great defense.
And that's a knack AJ Godhelf has. He can play against those bigger offensive players, and he just does a great job of slowing them down. Maybe trying to get it inside. They really base their offense down there.
Referee calls a jump ball. Not sure how that call can be made.
Yeah, I don't know what the ref saw right there. It was a late call, and it was the wrong call, more importantly.
It looked like he didn't want to call a foul, but he didn't want to let AB have an easy layup on that play.
Hey, it's the big game effect. These refs are second-guessing themselves.
Late in the shot clock, AB's going to try to get a shot off. Jake Pilecki down the baseline for two.
He's done that three times in a row, and they can't stop him on that baseline drive. Jake Pilecki scoring in bunches.
Great finish by Jake Pilecki using his left hand because he is a lefty, and a foul called. The AB fans do not like that call.
Such a deflating call right there. Would have led to a layup, and AB crowd would have gotten pumped up.
That call's probably a 4-point differential.
Oh, yeah, and you know when AB hits that layup, they're coming back, and they're playing pumped-up defense.
Now AB needs to box out on the free throw and play well on their next possession to keep momentum in their favor.
Key right here is play smart. No sloppy passes. You can't afford that right now this late in the game.
6:40 remaining in the game. AB's leading over Westford by 3.
No surprise again here. Coming down to the last minute. Trying to get it over half court.
Long pass, but it gets over.
Jake Pilecki wide open.
Getting
doubled
in the corner. Great pass down low.
And LaFrancis finishes off the great dish. This combo of Jake Pilecki and Kevin LaFrancis down low has been unstoppable.
The seniors for AB have played very well, doing their best to win this game.
And it looks like they've been in almost all the game for the big game situations.
Great finish by Kevin LaFrancis, and one.
This crowd is so pumped up right now. This building is going to explode. Kevin LaFrance is going to the line for one. He's hit so many contact shots this year. It's unbelievable.
He's had a tough time getting the ball down low tonight, but two straight possessions where he's made great plays.
Yeah, he was relatively quiet first three quarters, but you know he comes to play in the fourth quarter.
He's a crunch time performer.
As you see right there, when he hits that free throw, he's got ice in his veins.
He gives AB an 8-point lead. Just under a minute ago, it was a 3-point game.
AB just went on a run, as they're known to do. Tough three right there.
Westford hits the 3-pointer and calls the timeout. AB inbounding the ball. Westford just hit a 3-pointer and called the timeout. AB up by 5 with 5:45 left in this game.
AB's got to play smart. Got to play like Coach K has been teaching him all year. Don't make any mental mistakes. Good drive right there. Joey Flannery loses it but kicks it out.
Pelecki off the mark. LaFrancis.
A lot of offensive rebounds. There you go. Offensive rebounding pays off. AB's just too big right now. Looked like 4 or 5 offensive rebounds or a lot of tips. Tips.
AB gets the ball. I'm trying to get it down low to LaFrancis. Gets it there. AB with ball movement, getting it to Joey Flannery for 3.
Got it! Joey Flannery, big time player right now. Shows why he's the captain of this AB squad.
Huge 3-pointer for Joey Flannery.
Good defense on the other end. LaFrancis comes up with the board, looking for Joey Flannery on the wing. Doesn't quite get it there though that time.
AB slowing it down, setting up a half court play. Jake Pelecki with the ball at the top.
Interesting to see him at the point guard, but he's definitely improved his dribbling. Again, going down low.
Good pass to Ben Hoban for 3. Off the mark, but AB gets the rebound. And Joey Flannery to the basket.
Great take by Joey Flannery. Just gets to the rim at will. He uses that great athleticism and size he has.
A couple of huge plays by Joey Flannery.
Looks like a little bit of confusion. Ref thought it was a timeout, but the game will keep on going.
Westford's coach did not want a timeout.
Oh, and Joey Flannery almost gets a steal right there.
Westford misses the 3-pointer there. AB going the other way, up by 10 with 4:20 left in the game.
Good defense is going to win it right here. They're up 10, 4 minutes to go. If they play good defense, get out on the shooters, this game could be theirs.
Open. Jake Pelecki open for 3. Joey Flannery with a great rebound. And
unselfish passing. Just easy shot right there. Just misses. Good hustle by Jake Pelecki.
He missed 2 straight shots, but he hustled for the loose ball and got his team the ball back.
This AB squad just wants it more right now.
And AB calls a timeout, up by 10. Coming out of that timeout, AB has a 10-point lead with 3:50 left in the game.
AB's got to play smart defense and offense right now if they want to win this game. AB looking to inbound, gets it to LaFrancis, right back to Joey Flannery.
Great cross-court pass. AB now setting it up, trying to get it down low to Kevin LaFrancis.
Great move. And the foul. So close to the and one.
It's going to be key for AB late in this game to get it down low like they have, because LaFrancis is their anchor down low, making it tough for Westford to stop them.
Yeah, LaFrancis really stepped up in this fourth quarter. He's getting to the line often. He's scoring down low off of those offensive rebounds.
And he makes the first free throw, extending AB's lead to 11.
This is the largest lead of the night for AB. 11 points right now.
Westford has continued to come back in this game. but AB's mental toughness has made it very hard for Westford to complete a comeback.
And it's because they've been in this situation before that they know how to play smart. As Westford throws the ball out of bounds right there, a little miscommunication. It's not going to go down well in this fourth quarter. Looks like AB's starting to pull away, but they got to stay strong.
They can't let up one bit because Westford will just come back in this game.
Yeah, you don't want to get in that trap of just assuming you already won the game. Just keep playing hard. Good passing right now by AB, being strong.
Francis trying to get it down low, kicks it back out. Joey Flannery tries to take it to the basket but loses it.
Tough take right there. Joey Flannery thought he got fouled on that play. Looks like he just lost the ball though.
3 minutes to play. AB's leading by 11. Great block by Ben Hoban. Huge defensive play.
Wow. It's not really talked about that much, but Ben Hoban actually has great hops. He has a great understanding of where he needs to be to get those blocks.
Misses the floater, and it's going to go the other way.
Looks like LaFrancis getting a little bit too aggressive on the rebound. He's got to make sure he doesn't get frustrated. We've seen him get these technical fouls before. He's got to stay calm and level-headed right now, though.
AB also can't foul much anymore because then now in the bonus, Westford's going to be shooting 1-1. If AB fouls anywhere on the court, Westford gets 3 points without the clock running. And Matt Ellis hits both of them for Westford.
Back to a single-digit lead. Westford still in this full-court press. Looks like they're a little bit confused. Ryan Jan doesn't really know who he's guarding.
AB trying to get some ball movement, get good execution.
And they've been strong with the ball, always getting in that triple threat position.
Great pass by Joey Flannery to Jake Pilecki.
Looked like a foul right there. Westford defender came on down on Jake Pilecki hard and looked like a foul from behind, but no call.
Ryan Jan open for three for Westford, and he does not miss. That's, I believe, his fifth three-pointer for Westford tonight, and it's down to a six-point game with 2 minutes to play.
Yeah, and he cooled off in the middle of the game a little bit, but you can't forget about him. He'll kill you from deep.
He's made everything he's taken from deep tonight.
Jake Pilecki's got that killer instinct in his eye.
And a travel's called. Jake Pilecki wanted a foul call.
And he is angry. Thought that was a clean play. Good move right there. Just took the extra step.
Under 2 minutes to play now, a 6-point game.
Maybe he's got to buckle down right here. These are the plays that make champions.
Ryan Jan for three off the mark. Great closeout by Joey Flannery to force a tough shot.
Yeah, Joey Flannery has just played great defense throughout this game.
AB getting ball movement.
Good passing, trying to get it down low. Good take by Jake Pilecki. Just misses. Fights for the rebound, though.
Great rebound by AB there. And Westford fouls. 1:15 remaining in the game.
And you saw Kevin LaFrancis just get that little tip to Pilecki, letting him get that offensive board.
When the double bonus now, AB's going to be shooting 2 free throws. AJ Godhelf at the line.
You can see on the sideline, Jake Pilecki looks pretty tired, but you know he's going to play through the pain. He's a big-time player.
AJ misses the first one.
A little bit of confusion right there. Ben Hoban thought it was 1-1.
Ben Hoban fighting for the ball even when the play was dead. It's a good hustle play, though, if the play was not dead.
Oh, Steve, you can make me laugh every time.
Just over a minute to play, 6-point game. Westford driving to the basket. gets fouled.
Good take right there by Westford. AB's got to make sure they don't rack up these fouls, though.
Both teams have a lot of fouls.
Yeah, and it's been a physical game, and the fouls really reflect that.
Late in this game, AB's up, but they got to, when they're on their side of the court, they got to hit their free throws and play good defense. Westford's now shooting two. And he misses the first one.
And the key right here is when AB gets the ball back, they got to play good offense. Time is on their side. They got to move the ball around efficiently and get a good shot.
Westford makes the second free throw, making it a 5-point game.
Going with this full court press. But AB's not fazed. They've seen this before.
Westford's not going to foul yet, it doesn't look like. Great pass, but can't be handled. AB's going to slow it down, and AJ Godhelf with the three. Got it! Huge three-pointer by AJ Godhelf. Giving AB an 8-point lead with 50 seconds to play.
AJ Godhelf hit the dagger right there.
Shot to the heart by AJ Godhelf. Coming out of that timeout, Westwood's going to have the ball after that huge three-pointer by A.J. Godhelf.
Just cold-blooded right there. A.J. Godhelf not afraid to put away the game.
This game is between the two top teams in the DCL, and the winner of this game is on the fast track to winning the DCL.
Yeah, big game right here. Really.
Matt Ellis with the three-pointer for Westwood, and a timeout is called. 5-point game with 31 seconds to play. AB inbounding the ball, up by 5 with 31 seconds to play. Looks like Westford's going to have to foul.
Yeah, AB's got to play smart right here. Get a good pass, break the press, and hit the free throws if they're going to the line. They're going to foul right away. Joey Flannery going to the line. Big free throws right here, but you know he's going to hit them. He's a big-time player. He's got ice in his veins.
5-point lead for AB right now, hoping to extend it.
I mean, it was really a team thing.
Joey Flannery hits a free throw, giving AB a 6-point lead with 29 seconds to go. And he misses the second one.
Got to get back and play good defense. Ryan Jan looking like he wants to take a three.
He does, but misses it. Westford fighting for the rebound. And just get it, and a foul's called
on Jake Pilecki, and he's very frustrated. That could have gone either way, and Jake Pilecki just happened to end up with it.
It was a loose ball, but Westford shooting 1-1. AB leading by 6 points with 17 seconds to go. That was also the fourth foul on Jake Pilecki.
Yeah, but that could have gone either way. They were both fighting for it. They were both pushing each other. Just Jake Pilecki ended up with the foul.
Good hustle by both teams. 5-point lead for AB right now. Even if Westford makes this free throw, it's still a two-possession game in AB's favor.
But you know Westford can hit those threes. But AB's got to make sure they close out on the shooters.
And he makes both free throws for Westford.
Ryan Jan coming back into the game.
He was checked out quickly. And the referee will not allow him to come back into the game.
Shut down.
AB inbounding the ball up by 4 with 17 seconds left in the game.
Smart play right here.
Jake Pilecki has the ball and fouled. Shooting two free throws.
Really no time off the clock right there. Westford fouls very quickly.
AB needs to hit these free throws. Huge free throws right here for Jake Pilecki.
Yeah, he can really put the game away right here if he hits these. Tough
Jake
miss
Pilecki
right
misses
there.
A free throw. AB up by 4 with 16 seconds to play. Whether this free throw goes in or not, AB needs to play good defense without fouling, not allowing a quick, easy basket for Westford.
And Jake Pilecki hits it right there. Two-possession game right now.
Open three-pointer for Westford.
Misses.
Off the mark.
Good rebound by Jake Pilecki. And this one looks just about over. 6.4 seconds left. And who but Jake Pilecki to go to the line. He's played great so far.
Making all the hustle plays, including that one, grabbing the rebound. With 6 seconds to play, trying to extend the AB lead and seal the deal. And he makes the first one. It'd be almost impossible for Westford to come back now with only 6 seconds to play.
One more hit shot will make it a 3-possession game.
And he misses the second one, and the clock's winding down. Westford misses a shot, and AB wins it, 59-53 over their rivals, Westford. The crowd goes wild and storms the court. And AB wins it 59-53. Huge win for AB.
Hell of a win. They look like DCL champs right now.